up on your feet. What you mean to do is catch up with them. Bounce, bang, get up on your feet and help me get it.
When the eyes of the world are on you, it's natural to want to look your best. But that's left the Duchess of Cambridge with a rather hefty shopping bill at the end of 2017. This year, Kate has increasingly turned her back on high street staples in favor of designer labels such as DMG and Cream. Totting up all the new pieces she's worn throughout 2017 comes to a massive £119,000, $160,000, her most expensive year yet. Femmeur estimated that in 2016 she wore clothing worth more than £174,170, $233,072. However, this took into account items she already owned and rewore, making the total spend more likely to sit around the £100,000, $133,800 mark. The Femmeur reveals the new purchases Kate has been sporting on official engagements, only taking into account items that haven't been seen before in public. These include her most expensive outfits of the year, the dusty pink ensemble she wore to Pippa's wedding, that came in at £11,500, $15,400, and a Chanel outfit she sported in Paris costing almost £13,000, $17,400. Kate and William skipped Christmas with the royal family in favor of spending it with the Middletons in Berkshire, but joined the Queen just after the New Year. Kate recycled the £1,541 designer coat by Sportmax, the Max Mara Diffusion line, as she arrived at St. Mary Magdalene Church. She added some new accessories to bring the look up to date for 2017. From the first official engagement of the new year, Kate visited North London's Emma Ferrard Centre, followed by Child Grief in the UK later that afternoon. She opted for Eponine, a London-based label, which takes inspiration from the silhouettes of the 1950s and 1960s teamed with accessories we've seen before. Kate brightened up a cold January day in winter florals as she arrived at the ICA in London in an embroidered dress by Urban. She attended the Institute of Contemporary Arts in Carlton House Terrace with William and Harry to speak at a briefing outlining the next phase of their Heads Together campaign. Her shoes and clutch bag were recycled, so were not counted towards the overall total. Kate wore a totally new ensemble for a visit to the East Anglia's Children's Hospices in Clydingham, Norfolk, where she was seen comforting grieving parents. Her blouse was by chic French brand Gerard Darrell, and featured embroidery on the frilled collar and a tie neck. Just a peek was visible under her emerald green two-piece from her high street favorite Hobbs, costing £299, $400. Kate paired her quilted ski jacket by Perfect Moment with a pair of black jeggings from Zara as she joined William and Harry for a relay race at London's Olympic Park. She teamed the outfit with New Balance trainers, and what would Kate do estimated that her turtleneck was £161 for Iris and Dean. Despite the sporty occasion, she couldn't resist adding a touch of sparkle with never seen before a stray 167 earrings, costing a whopping £3,864, $5,170. Kate and William attended a conference in London, where they discussed mental health issues with journalists during Children's Mental Health Week. Kate opted for an Oscar de la Renta skirt suit in magenta, with a peplum jacket combined with a flattering fit and flare skirt. Although what would Kate do, writers suspected she may already have worn it to the Queen's Christmas lunch, there were no photos to confirm this, so it was counted as a new item. The Duchess successfully championed understated glamour for her red carpet appearance, her first time at the BAFTAs. Kate looked every inch the best-dressed attendee in a bespoke off-the-shoulder Alexander McQueen gown. The dress was cut in a drop-waist style and covered in a delicate floral pattern, perfect for the spring season ahead, and she tuned the gown with a clutch by the same designer. Kate, who is royal patron and honorary air commandant of the RAF Air Cadets, arrived to meet young people at RAF Wittering near Peterborough, in a more dressed-down look than usual. She sported a red blazer by Philosophy di Lorenzo Serafini with recycled black skinny jeans and a turtleneck. Attending the UK-India-Europe culture reception at Buckingham Palace, the Duchess dazzled in a metallic midi dress by Erdem. She teamed the shimmering dress with sparkling pumps by Oscar de la Renta and £1,087 earrings by Lita Gonger. The name may sound familiar to royal watchers, as Kate wore a dress by the Indian designer on her visit to Mumbai last year. Her blue jacket flecked with silver thread cost £398. $532, but the dress is believed to be custom-made. What would Kate do? Estimates have cost her around £644, $862. Kate recycled an elegant blue-gray twill coat by Michael Kors as she joined the royal family to unveil a memorial to service personnel killed in the Iraq and Afghanistan conflicts. However, she debuted a new wide-brimmed navy hat by Rock&Co. Kate celebrated St. Patrick's Day with a pint of Guinness on her first official engagement with William after his epic dad dancing during a Wild Lights weekend in Bermuda. Kate wore a bespoke green coat by Catherine Walker with contrasting black collar and cuffs. She teamed the coat with any London court shoes and an etchy green clutch. For her first engagement in Paris, Kate attended the British Embassy to launch Les Voices the Leaders, a year-long celebration of UK French links. Kate finished the evening at the ambassador's residence, where she dazzled in an ice blue Jenny Packham dress. She made sure all eyes were on her during the glittering gala dinner at the stunning official residence of the British ambassador, Edward Llewellyn, Lord Llewellyn of Speke, David Cameron's former chief of staff at Downing Street. Kate wore a chic Chanel suit of choice bound to the light for shine vistas in muted shades of black, grey and burgundy, on her second day in Paris. To offset the outfit, she naturally chose a Chanel handbag in burgundy with an enamel handle. She teamed the outfit with Cartier earrings, making the ensemble her most expensive look for the year so far. Later, she attended a rugby match wearing knee-high boots, however Kate do estimate to have cost £785. Kate stunned in a floor-length forest green lace found by Temperley London, which appeared to be a new addition to her wardrobe. However, according to the team at What Would Kate Do, she had already worn it to a private event earlier this year. Therefore the price tag wasn't taken into account, but she was sporting rather pricey new accessories, Kiki McDonough candy pink, tourmaline and green amethyst drop earrings. The Duchess looked stunning in a crimson Marchese and Otto gown teamed with a jeweled belt, maroon heels and a mulberry plush bag, as she joined a host of stars for the opening of the musical 42nd Street in London. The Duke and Duchess of Cambridge and Prince Harry joined families of the Westminster terror attack victims for a special service at Westminster Abbey, 2 weeks after the tragedy. Kate wore recycled Missoni coat and Sylvia Fletcher for Lock&Co.hat, but carried a new black clutch. At St. George's Chapel, near Windsor Castle, Kate put on an elegant display in a custom-made cream coat by favorite designer Catherine Walker, which she'd worn before. Recycled, however, she sported a new hat, the Jacqueline style by Lock & Company, and a new clutch. Kate welcomed London Marathon runners at Kensington Palace to offer her support to those taking part on behalf of Heads Together. The mother of two opted for an uncharacteristically dressed down look with a striped top from Italian label Luisa Stagnoli, skinny jeans and her trusty Supergod trainers as she welcomed the runners to her London residence. The Duchess, along with her husband and Prince Harry, visited the new Global Academy, a new West London school which builds mental health welding classes into its curriculum. She chose a fiery red two-piece Armani suit for her visit to the Global Academy, to officially open the new state school later that day. Kate and William dropped in on the Scott Mills show to surprise Radio 1 DJ Adele Roberts, who is running the London Marathon for their Heads Together campaign. The Duchess wore a blouse by Temperley London, one of her go-to designer labels, with flared cuffs, tiered ruffles and knitted pointelle fabric. Kate chatted with children from Vauxhall Primary School about the creatures she has at home in Norfolk on her visit to Whitford, a Farms for City Children project in Gloucestershire. Her casual outfit was made up of recycled items aside from AJ Crew cashmere t-shirt. K-35 looked elegant in a pastel blue coat dressed by Amelia Wickstain, which she paired with her trusty Luke heels and blue topaz and diamond drop earrings in white gold from Kiki McDonough. Held at the first Buckingham Palace, the Queen's 8,000 guests thronged to catch a glimpse of the royals on duty, which included the Duke of Edinburgh. An icy blue number by Christopher Kane, which seen on Kate twice before, was her outfit of choice, originally seen at the Olympics opening ceremony in London, and then again at the annual Order of the Garter service at Windsor Castle in 2014. Her new hat, which matched perfectly, is estimated to have cost around £600 from one of her go-to milliners. The Duchess took on the attentive sister role, and was helping Pippa with her wedding gown as they entered St. Mark's Chapel on the big day. Kate wore a pale pink maxi dress from Alexander McQueen Kate, and an elegant fascinator from milliner Jane Taylor. The Duchess looked glamorous as she joined celebrities including baker Mary Berry, supermodel Jerry Hall and actress Dame Judi Dench at the event. And she channeled the feel of the day by wearing a green floral print dress by Lucas. Kate was stuck to the nautical color scheme in skinny blue J. Crew trousers, a white Zara jacket and low-heeled courts. Also by J. Crew, was on duty in her role as patron of the 1851 Trust, attending the charity's Land Rover Bar Roadshow at the Docklands Sailing and Water Sports Center. It may have been the Queen's 91st birthday, but Kate Middleton and her two young children, Prince George and Princess Charlotte, were the stars of the show on a packed Buckingham Palace balcony. The young royals joined the Queen, Duke of Edinburgh and the other members of the family as they waved to large crowds outside the palace, and watched an RAF flypast for Trooping the Colour, the Queen's birthday parade. Despite temperatures soaring to almost 30°C, Kate kept her cool in a white lace outfit by Alexander McQueen as she joined the Queen and Prince William at Royal Ascot, wearing a bespoke version of one of the designer's mini dresses. Kate was channeling Jackie O'Sheik as she arrived at London's B&A to open the new exhibition spaces in a £1,790 tweed dress by Gucci. The Duchess walked into the SW19 Grounds in a polka dot dress by Dolce & Gabbana, holding a white Victoria Beckham handbag. The royal donned a powder blue dress by Queen by Thornton Ragazzi, featuring a fitted short sleeve bodice and full midi skirt evening at the Natural History Museum as she joined Sir David Attenborough to unveil the new blue whale skeleton. The royal looked the picture of summery perfection in a white dress, with a vibrant floral print, and ditched her customary clutch for a white Victoria Beckham tote bag as she cheered on family friend Roger Federer. Kate ensured she made an impression as the royal tour got underway, touching down in Warsaw in typically stylish fashion in an Alexander McQueen woolen silk blend twill peplum coat costing £1,995. She kicked off the family's five-day visit with a sartorial nod to Poland, wearing white trimmed with red accessories in homage to the country's flag, and even her dazzling jewelry from G.H. Collins & Sons matched the color scheme. Kate pulled out all the stops for a birthday party held in honor of the Queen at Warsaw's Lazy Yankee Park. Flying a flag, once again for European fashion, she chose a dress by Polish designer Gosia Paczynska. Similar designs cost £1,460, teamed with an old pearl necklace and dazzling Balenciaga earrings. The Duchess took a leaf out of Meghan Markle's book, opting for pretty floral separates from Harry's girlfriend's favorite designer, Erdem. She teamed a £760 skirt with a matching top that Kate watchers have so far been unable to track down, but similar style carry a £300 price tag. Kate channeled Jackie O in a custom Catherine Walker creation as she did Eurytzenia to Warsaw and set Putin tag to Berlin. Cornflower blue coat thought to be a nod to Germany's national flower was teamed with her Gianvita Rossi pumps again, and she styled her hair into a chic chignon. In another subtle nod to her host country's flag, Kate wore a sizzling red number 4, yet another garden party for the Queen, held at the British ambassadorial residence. The Duchess won plaudits from fashion commentators and the crimson chiffon maxi from Alexander McQueen, teamed with a pair of Prada pumps she owns in two different colors. Kate pulled off yet another feat of diplomatic dressing as she channeled the gold of the German flag for a visit to Heidelberg's Cancer Institute and Old Market. It was an overcast morning, but Kate brought a ray of sunshine to proceedings in the bespoke lace number by Jenny Packham, which she paired with her trusty nude espadrille wedges from Monsoon, and a small clutch in a matching shade. In an uncharacteristically casual look for the Duchess, she swapped her Jenny Packham dress for an old Breton top from Hugo Boss, and a pair of skinny jeans, to partake in a rowing race coming in just seconds behind her husband. Kate is fond of Zara's £25 design, and Thursday's denims, teamed with her trusty Supergod trainers, are believed to be a similar style. She teamed it with a pair of sword pearl earrings, and recycled both her £550 Prada heels, and her pearl bracelet which once belonged to the Princess of Wales. Diana wore the three-strand pearl bracelet almost 30 years ago, with her iconic Catherine Walker pearl-studded strapless gown during the 1989 trip to Hong Kong. The Duchess ensured she went out with a bang, saving her most stylish look yet for Friday morning, when she left Berlin for Hamburg. She donned a custom Amelia Wickstead dress, and recycled her Gianvita Rossi pumps. She added a touch of sparkle with her £3,900 Kiki McDonough lavender amethyst pair and oval drop earrings. Yet again Kate struck the right note in a pale grey Catherine Walker coat dress as she visited the Commonwealth War Graves Commission cemetery just outside Ypres in Belgium. Venetian wool colored dress featured hand applique top corduroys, and the pale gray color was the perfect shade for the solemn occasion. Kate, 35, who was dressed smartly in a green Prada dress, returned with William and Harry to their mother's former home to view floral tributes to the late Princess Diana ahead of the 20th anniversary of her death in a Paris car crash on August 31, 1997. She looked radiant in a 795-pound powder blue lace dress by Temporary London, which skimmed over her bump. The Duchess of Cambridge stepped out for the second time in a week as she surprisingly joined husband Prince William and Prince Harry to hail the next generation of young sports coaches in London. She was an unannounced addition to the event alongside the royal brothers as they saluted 150 apprentices who have graduated from the royal's own mentoring program. The Duchess of Cambridge rocked a much more sporty look as she visited the National Tennis Centre in London in her role as patron of the Lawn Tennis Association, her first solo engagement since taking a break from public duties. Kate, 35, was the epitome of casual chic in recycled Mondial London tuxedo track pants worth an eye-watering £220. And 170-pound Nigeria VaporMax trainers, loved by footballers such as Cristiano Ronaldo and Rio Ferdinand. Kate, who is royal patron of the charity PLACE2B, spent a day at the school leaders forum in central London. The expectant mother looked chic in a simple burgundy dress by goat with a button detail on one shoulder, displaying just the tiniest hint of a baby bump under the loose-fitting number, which she paired with black heels. The Queen meets senior members of the royal family at an event to honor the British soldiers who died in World War I on Saturday, while Princes William and Harry enjoyed a day out at the rugby. The Duchess and other royals were joined by Prime Minister Theresa May at the Festival of Remembrance, which was held at the Royal Albert Hall in London. The Queen, 91, asked Charles to take on her duties as she observed the service from a nearby balcony alongside 96-year-old husband Prince Philip, whose wreath was laid by his equerry. Kate, who wore a coat by BMG and carried a new Emmy clutch bag, took her place alongside Sophie Wessex. The Duchess dressed her burgeoning funk in a recycled 680-pound coat from GOAT, adding knee-high rustling Bromley boots of Jaguar Land Rover Solly Hall manufacturing plant. Kate looked radiant as ever as she arrived at the Royal Variety Performance, wearing a floor-length bespoke Jenny Poppin dress. She burst into fits of giggles when a Duke gamer took part in a comedy skit, obligingly shouting a catchphrase "such fun" whenever Harry requested them to from the stage at the London Palladium. LK dazzled in a red gold fashion dress and monochrome LK Vanakota. She chatted to BBC Radio 5 Live's Nikki Campbell and McFly's Tom Fletcher about children's emotions as part of the Children's Global Media Summit at Manchester Central Convention Centre.